to Best Way to Study. In this video, let's see BITSAT exam detailed analysis. We are also going to see the difficulty level section wise, and we are also going to see what is expected cutoff this year, okay, for BITSAT 2020. So now let's begin this video without any delay. So coming to the overall difficulty level, overall difficulty level of the paper is moderate. Moderate in the sense, few students told the paper is easy, few students told the paper was moderate. Okay, so out of entire paper, students told physics is difficult. Out of whole paper, students told mostly they concentrated on physics and chemistry section as they are a bit lengthy and time consuming. And coming to max, max paper is easy. Said max paper is moderate and physics paper is very difficult. And coming to physics, 12 plus questions are difficult. 10 plus questions are easy. And rest of the questions are moderate. Coming to physics, this is analysis coming to physics. So now coming to chemistry, eight plus questions are difficult. Students told eight plus questions are difficult. 12 plus questions are very easy and rest of the questions are moderate. Okay. So now let's see what is the subject wise analysis coming to mathematics. Okay, so coming to mathematics, 10 plus questions are difficult. 14 plus questions are easy. Rest of the questions are difficult. Okay, rest of the questions are moderate. Okay, so students need to concentrate on physics. Maths is moderate level. It's not so easy. It's not so hard. Max is at moderate level and the level of physics is very, very difficult. Okay. Physics is difficult. So concentrate on physics. Coming to questions. Few questions were asked on concept based. What is concept based? The questions were framed in the sense that if you know the concept, you can answer those. So in such a way, few questions were framed. Okay, so questions are concept based. Few questions are directly asked, like direct questions were asked. Okay. And few questions are indirect and tricky questions. Okay, so few questions are direct questions and few questions are indirect and tricky questions. Students need to concentrate on these indirect and tricky questions because they are time consuming. Okay. These questions are time consuming because they need to invest much time on these kind of questions. And logical reasoning. Coming to logical reasoning. It is at the level of moderate and students told English is bit tough compared to previous year's paper. Okay, so logical reasoning is moderate and English is bit tough compared to the previous year's paper. Okay, and coming to chemistry. So now let's see how many number of questions were asked subject wise. Coming to chemistry, 40 questions were asked. Coming to physics, 40 questions were asked. Logical reasoning, 10 questions were asked. English, 15 questions were asked. Coming to part 4. 45 questions were asked. Okay. Students who are going to attempt this BITSAT exam in future should concentrate on physics and English because दिस ईयर इन स्पेशली दिस ईयर फिजिक्स इज बिट हार्ड, इंग्लिश इज बिट हार्ड एंड मैथ्स इज एट द लेवल ऑफ मॉडरेट, इवन केमिस्ट्री एंड लॉजिकल इज एट द लेवल ऑफ मॉडरेट. ओके एंड नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट विल बी द कट ऑफ. सो कमिंग टू द कट ऑफ फॉर बी ऑनर्स, बी ऑनर्स केमिकल cut off is going to be 275 plus. Okay, for BE honors civil cut off is going to be above 270. For BE honors electrical and electronics, cut off is going to be high, it's going to be above 330 plus. Okay, for BE honors mechanical cut off is going to be 310 plus. For BE honors computer science cut off is going to be, for MSc chemistry the cut off is going to be above 260 in BITS Pilani. Okay, so coming to MSc economics cut off is going to be above 300. Okay, so this is just an expected cutoff. Exact cutoff will be based upon many things. If the paper is really easy, then cutoff will increase. If the paper is difficult, the cutoff will come down. So exact cutoff will be based on many other things. So coming to last minute preparation tips, first most important tip is, Don't start new topics. See, when you're left only with few days or few weeks for your exam, so it's better not to start any new topic, because if you start any new topic, you will be confused and you will also tend to forget the things which you have already studied. So don't go with new topics. Okay, so second important thing is, study important topics. And next important thing is, refer to short notes. Okay, whatever short notes you prepared while your preparation, just go through that short notes and revise it quickly. Okay, mock tests. Next important tip is, mock test and analyze your mock test. Okay, it's very important to take the mock test, because only once you take the mock test, you will understand, are you able to solve the paper and how much time you're taking to solve the paper or to solve a particular question, and are you getting stuck in any particular topic or subject. All these things you will get to know only when once you take mock test. Okay, So first take mock test, and after taking mock test, analyze your mock test and make sure you don't repeat those mistakes in final exam. Okay, so next is, go through previous papers are very important, because more than 40% of similar kind of questions and its patterns will be asked every year. So it's always good to refer to at least last 4 to 5 years previous papers. Okay, so next important tip is, don't study the same subject for long hours. Okay, So once you study the same subject or same topic for long hours, nothing will go into your mind. Just keep changing the topics or subjects frequently, okay? And make sure at least once in every 2 hours, take a short break, okay? Revise, okay? The things which you have already studied, revise them thoroughly. Revision helps you to memorize the things which you have already studied, okay? Make sure you arrange all the essential things day before exam only, okay? Your admit card, your ID proof, all these things, make sure you arrange them before exam day only so that there will be no tension on the exam day. Extreme values. Next cheat code is no extreme values. What does this mean? For example, let's think there is a question and there are four options. Option A is 2, option B is 4, option B is 8, option D is 21. Okay, so see, out of these four options, which is having extreme value? Extreme means different value. This is having different value, so you can't put this as answer. Okay. You have to guess only, you have to put only one of these three options as the answer, okay? You should avoid extreme values, okay? Do no extreme values. E cheat code kadvaitte ippudu manam chuddam, okay? So, for question undi and four options icharu 2, 4, 8, 21. Ivi four values. Aa four values lo మొత్తం డిఫరెంట్ గా విభిన్నంగా ఉన్న ఆప్షన్ ఏదైతే ఉంది, ఇది 21. మిగిలినవన్నీ దగ్గర దగ్గరగా ఉన్న ఆప్షన్స్, కానీ ఇది మాత్రం చాలా డిఫరెంట్ గా ఉంది. ఇలాంటి డిఫరెంట్ ఆప్షన్ ని మాత్రం పెట్టుకోవద్దు. గెస్ చేస్తున్నప్పుడు దీన్ని అవాయిడ్ చేయండి. మిగిలిన త్రీలోనే ఒక ఆన్సర్ అనేది మీరు పెట్టుకోవచ్చు, ఓకేనా? సో నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్, నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్. Next is all of the above, none of the above. See, when you have all of the above as one of the option, you can go for it. You have all of the above as one of the option and you don't know what is the correct answer, then there are high chances that all of the above is the correct answer. Then you can happily go for it, okay? And if you find none of the above as one of the option and if you don't know what is the correct answer, don't go for it, okay? There are very least probabilities of none of the above being the correct answer. Okay, so that's why always go for all of the above and never go for none of the above. Okay, so ఇప్పుడు మనం all of the above, none of the above options ఏంటో చూద్దాం. ఓకే, ఒక క్వశ్చన్ ఉంది. ఆ క్వశ్చన్ ఆప్షన్స్ వచ్చేసి ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్ ఉంది అండ్ మీకు ఆ ఆన్సర్ కరెక్ట్గా తెలియకపోతే అప్పుడు మీరు ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్ అనేది పెట్టొచ్చు, ఎందుకంటే చాలా ఛాన్సెస్ ఉన్నాయి ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్ కరెక్ట్ అవ్వడానికి. సో ఇలాంటప్పుడు మీరు ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్ ఆప్షన్ చూస్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. సెకండ్ ఏంటంటే, మీకు మీకు ఇచ్చిన ఆప్షన్స్లో నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్ ఉంది అండ్ మీకు ఆ కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్ తెలియదు అన్నప్పుడు నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్ చూస్ చేసుకోకండి, ఎందుకంటే చాలా తక్కువ కేసులో, చాలా తక్కువ ఛాన్సెస్లో నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్ అనేది కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్ అవుతుంది, సరేనా? నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్. నెక్స్ట్ ఈజ్ ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్. So, what is elimination method? When you have four options, using your logic, using the concept which you know which is related to this question, try to eliminate the irrelevant options. Okay, so then out of four options, after eliminating the irrelevant options, you will be left with only two options. Then you can happily guess and put one of these options. Okay, this is called elimination method. Using your logic and your common sense and the concept which you know related to the question, just eliminate irrelevant options. Okay, so ఇప్పుడు మనం ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్ అంటే ఏంటో చూద్దాం. ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్ ఏంటంటే, యా దాట్స్ ఇట్ ఫర్ టుడే. హోప్ యూ ఫౌండ్ దిస్ వీడియో యూస్ఫుల్. థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ ఫర్ వాచింగ్ దిస్ వీడియో. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you will never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And for more BitSat videos, make sure you watch in the description box below. Thanks for watching.